Welcome to Channel Shepard Hall. Today, Dragon's Maze just came out on MTGO, so I'm doing a triple DGM draft, for which I have just a little bit of experience, which is actually very helpful for this format. Alright, let me first read this card. So, Flesh is just Scavenge, and then Blood is... Blood is... Fighting, much better version of fighting. So it's actually a pretty strong card. Let's see. Yeah, the Rhysus pack is actually pretty dry. Flux Charger is good, and I think Battering Crassus is really good. Beetle Form Mage is also just fine. But I'm definitely all about Flesh and Blood in this pack. It's a versatile card, a really good removal spell. Just can contribute to dealing a lot of damage at one time. Or just down them. Fling style. So yeah, that's definitely the pick. That does kind of commit me to Jund. I don't really care about that though, not really. Like the next best card is probably Flux Charger. And actually, I think Battering Crassus is pretty close to being the next best card. Might just be, actually, because it does keep you in just green, and it has a lot of synergy in this format. It's one of the only evolved creatures, and this format does drag on pretty long, so having something in play that continues to grow and has trample at the same time is actually pretty good. And for that reason, I'm going to be taking this card without a doubt. This card's really good in this format, I think. I'm kind of curious what they took over an uncommon. Could have been a few things, or someone who just didn't know the format that well. But yeah, I would love to be all about the +1/+1 counters in this format, opening myself up to a lot of synergies. So I'll probably take any card with Unleash, any card with Evolve, and any card with Scavenge, which really doesn't add up to that much. But there are a few, and I'll probably just take them all. Feral Animalist. It's pretty good with Blood Rush, with, I mean, there's a lot of synergies. Blood Rush, Scavenge, just Pump in general, obviously. So, it's a pretty good card. The Gatekeepers are fine, since there's so many gates. There's also tons of Clue Stones. You definitely don't need to pick up the Clue Stones early. In fact, you know what's weird? The Gate is missing out of this pack. That's really early to take a gate. Catch and Release is pretty strong. I'm surprised anybody would take a gate over that. Deputy of Acquittals is a pretty reasonable card also, but I definitely would have taken Catch and Release. Feral Animalist again. It's not good enough for me to take a second copy, I think. Especially with this card in the pack. This card's actually, I value this card really highly. Yeah, definitely taking that. Let's see. So we're doing pretty good so far. We're actually not even committed to black. We could still end up playing white or blue. Probably black, but just keep it in mind, we're open. This card I think is fine in the DGR, but not really so much in this format. Mutant's Prey, that's a card we could definitely pick up later on, and the card we also don't want to play more than maybe one of, unless we have a lot of synergies. And I almost want to just take the Windrake on the off chance that we do end up blue. I think that's correct here. Steeple Rock is also fine, but I would rather take Windrake, or maybe, you know what, actually I'm not sure if I'd rather be Rug or Naya, and that's really what it depends on, so, but obviously it's too late to change. Toil is fine, Toil Trouble, you know, Toil's obviously the main card, but when you're playing an aggressive deck, that could just be a ton of damage on turn 6. Like, if they have 4 cards in hand, that is 8 damage. That's absurd. It's a lot of damage. But we definitely have to take this card. just too good with the Crassus and just in general to have synergy. This card's also playable for sure. Yeah, kind of don't like passing Toil and Trouble, but I definitely think it's justified. The gates are going quick. This card's good. It enables Battalion, and it's also a good blocker. So in this format, it's not nearly as good as DGR. Final Burst. I mean, this pack is pretty dry for us. Sin Collector is good, and I would play that card, but I don't think we're getting into Orzhov. The Gatekeeper here is the next card I would take, but I'm pretty sure we're just going to be Jund, so I'm just going to take this and maybe play it. It's not very good, obviously. Spike Jester. I like that. Yeah, it's not very good, but it's definitely playable. It's just, it's like kind of just Lava Axe. If we have cards with Trample or Flying. Rot Farm Skeleton. It's not that bad. And it's definitely better than every card in this pack except for potentially the Guild Gate. Our deck's not really a Gatekeeper deck, so take the Skeleton. I guess it's good at evolving things, so that's actually a pretty good reason to take it. Some reasonable cards still in this pack. Down and Dirty's fine. I think I'm going to take Mutant's Prey, though. This is also not really a Cluestone deck. Doesn't feel like it is, at least. Though, I would like to have some gates to cast these really hard to cast cards. So I might start valuing those a little higher. Well, I mean, I haven't seen any yet, I think. Not for me, so. Bunch of unplayables. Maybe Mending Touch actually is playable, I don't know. That card is bad. So this card like essentially enables you to just to attack with everything. And then when your guys die, you kill their creatures. It's really bad. I don't know what the design process was behind that card. So Clear a Path. Not main deckable, obviously. Yeah, we'll take the Wear and Tear. But there is the 05 for 2 Defender, which is a card that is pretty good. And we may end up boarding it in. I'm going to go ahead and hide. Mending Touch, Clear Path. Okay. So we have one card with counters other than the Renegade Crassus. So we're looking to get more of those. Okay, so Far and Away is generally going to be the best card in this pack. Skylasher seems interesting to me. I mean, the only relevant ability really is Protection from Blue. So, definitely taking it. It's also a 2-drop. Checking out this pack quickly here. Yeah, this pack's not that exciting for me. It is a decent pack. Far and Away, Pilfer Plans, this Snare guy. All of those are pretty good. Okay, so this one's pretty sweet. Toil and Trouble, Spike Jester, and Thrashing Moss Dog. And I don't know what this card does. That card's fine. Helps you get in with all your guys, so maybe I would like to table that. Definitely taking a creature, so it's between Spike Jester and Thrashing Moss Dog. Spike Jester seems really powerful in multiples, even, especially. But the Moss Dog, does give me another synergy with Crisis. Actually, you know what? That synergy is not good at all. Is this too slow? Obviously, it's not going to matter by the time it happens. So I think the Spike Jester is the pick. Our mana is going to be really tough to pull off. And there's a Guild Gate for us, but there's also a lot of playables. I guess these two are the big ones. Both of these are really good. I think it's just the cat. Putrefy is good, but we're really aggressive right now. And we have a couple removal spells. I don't think they're as important as just having a card like this, which is either a creature or a card that lets you attack. So passing a gate there feels bad, though. Yeah, we're going to need... I mean, there's going to be many more opportunities for gates. So maybe if we end up with two, I guess I would be happy. Okay, here... I think this is a gate pick. What does this card do? The card's okay. But we're not white, so... yeah, it would be, I think Down and Dirty would be the next card. So yeah, the gate actually gets it this time. Fatal Fumes is really bad. If you compare it to Last Gasp, you can tell it's worse, but the truth is, not as compared to Disfigure. It basically says the same thing Disfigure does, but for 3 more mana. For 4 mana, you can maybe kill a 3 drop with it, if you're lucky. Just usually going to kill a 2 drop. So I just think it's really bad. This pack is really, really dry for us. I guess I'm taking a Clue Stone. In this deck, I really want to be on, like, maybe one Clue Stone. Let's make it a Rakdos so that we can Blood Rush in the same turn. Well, another really dry pack. I guess Mutant's Prey. I mean, two of these is pretty much the maximum, and we really don't have enough cards to make it work still. I don't think I want to play two Clue Stones in this deck. Yeah, I don't know. It's possible. We'll take the Mutant Spray anyway. So Morgue Burst. Power of the card return this way. That gives us a little reach. Well, it's a little expensive, but that's probably okay. And then Drown in Filth. Not good enough. I think it's not good enough. And then the Gleam of Battle here, I almost consider taking that. As a 6-drop, it's better than Morgue Burst, but... This one's on color, and it's also direct damage, so all right, here we go. I've not seen one of these guys yet. Definitely the pick. Definitely a great card for our deck. There's so many showstoppers. These are all pretty much unplayable for us. I guess we take this one so that we don't play against it. It is big in the butt. I'd like to pick up more Rakdos Drakes. Those are pretty good with the Crassus. If you go turn 3 Crassus into turn 4 Drake, you have a 4/3 and a 3/4 flying. So you know what else would be nice though? More ways to evolve this card. Especially past the 4-3 stage. So we need cards with either 5 power or 4 tough, yeah, 4 toughness. Those aren't in, I think, very big supply. And we're really light on creatures right now, too. Okay, there's a card with 5 power and 4 toughness. I don't know how I feel about a 6 drop in this deck, but obviously we're taking it anyway, so I guess we could play more clue stones after all. Oh, 6-3 haste? That's a little spicier than the Maze Behemoth, I think. Yeah, definitely is. Actually, you know what? I probably should have picked the monocolored creatures can't block this turn card. I already have one copy of Regenerate Target Creature. And neither of them are main deckable, so just couldn't hurt to have one of each in the sideboard.